This new learning series is designed to give you all the information you need to know to buy a tumble dryer. Step by step, we'll connect all of them in a compressed summary that you can download from the direct link provided in the description. We'll see pros and cons, which are effectively all the benefits of having a tumble dryer. Setup and location, dimensions, standard and related deviations, capacity and number of people that it would suit, and finally, different technologies, which is strictly connected with time, power consumption and costs. So, let's dive into it. To start with, let's define what is a tumble dryer. A tumble dryer is a powered household appliance that it is used to remove moisture from a lot of clothing. Let's now look at advantages and disadvantages. Among the advantages, it's compact. It takes definitely less space than a clothesline or a clothes hider. Time saver and fast dry, because you can take clothes from a washing machine and put them straight into the dryer. This takes definitely less time than hanging them in the clothes hider. Depending on technology and system adopted, that we'll see later on, it reduces the overall humidity in the room, especially when compared with the clothes hider. Hence, you will likely resolve and improve a lot of problems with mold. Among disadvantages, certain type of dryers, low-end models, might overheat, hence damage clothes, especially synthetic ones. But the new dryers with sensor have basically resolved this issue. Clothes might become less soft and they might even shrink, because when rotating, without air circulating, they tend to lose fibers. In fact, due to that, you would need to clean often the fluff filter in the dryer. Cost of the dryer and running expenses are often the main stopper for consumers. But in the last section of this e-learning, you will have a great understanding. It is very simple, and you will be able to calculate the costs related to the energy consumption for a specific dryer model that is on the market. Let's now move to setup and location. The dryer can be either standalone or integrated in a washer dryer machine. But this machine looks fantastic on paper, but it comes with great limitations. In fact, the drying capacity in weight is lower when compared to the washing capacity. As you can see in this great example from a Miele washer dryer, it has 8 kg max washing capacity and only 5 kg drying capacity. This is the proportion that you will always find regardless of the model. Hence, or you run the machine at half load, or you would need to split the drying into parts. The whole process takes very long, because it has to wash and dry, of course. But it's definitely a compact solution when compared of having two standalone machines. To save space, a standalone dryer can be stacked onto the washing machine. But to do this, you would need the stacking kit. This will secure them together, and the machines have to be stackable. Generally, they are standard size. We'll see more later, and you can understand that from the manufacturer website. Example, this one in the Bosch website. If you have the space, maybe in a proper laundry, you can just place washing machine and dryer side by side. Some tumble dryers have a water container, which is effectively like a drawer. If you are thinking to buy one of those models, you have to remember that it would need some space to be removed. Air hose access is something to be considered if you are opting for a vented dryer. let's now look at dimensions. Standard dimensions are 60 by 60 by 85, which is 23.5 by 23.5 by 33.5 inches. Width and depth are dimensions that might vary. In fact, you might find shorter versions of dryers that might adapt to bespoke spaces, but be aware that non-standard machines come always at a premium. Looking now at capacity. The capacity of a dryer, similarly to the one of a washing machine, is measured in kilograms. The capacity of a tumble dryer refers to the dry weight of laundry, that is, the weight before we put clothes into the washing machine. As a ballpark figure, a single person would not need more than a 7 kg dryer. A couple would be fine with an 8 to 9 kg capacity, while a large family should stick with the dryers larger than 9 kg. However, these references are very subjective and largely depend on how often you will be willing to run your dryer. It is also important to consider that for the same weight of clothes, a larger dryer would consume more. Technology, for many, is one of the most important, if not the most important feature. Now, you can find dryers with touch display that can be connected to the Wi-Fi and partly managed remotely. In fact, in this case, they will become part of a network of appliances, so-called Internet of Things, acronym IoT. They can have different predefined drying cycles and they can be fully customized, but, of course, this will come at a cost. All dryers are generally controlled with a timer. This has a known risk of overheating the clothes. Newer dryers, especially heat pump dryers, have a moisture sensor. Clothes rotating in the dryer are continuously touching the bars. In this way, the dryer can sense the humidity. Therefore, in this case, you are generally allowed to set up the humidity level and you get an estimated completion time. Tumble dryers can be mainly split in two categories. The minority with gas dryers, as they are generally used in countries where the electric energy is rather expensive, but the most popular category is the one of the electric dryers. Now, probably one of the most interesting parts, especially for engineers. Electric tumble dryers have seen tech advancement in three successive technologies: vented dryers, condenser dryers, and the newest heat pump tumble dryers. Let's analyze the working principles along with pros and cons. In vented dryers, a fan sucks fresh air from the room, laundry, kitchen, etc. This air is heated up by a series of heaters, which simply are resistive elements. The hot air passes in the room, it gets loaded with moisture from the clothes, and it is then expelled from the hose outside. Therefore, in this case, you would really need a hose to blow air outside. And for the fact that the machine sucks air from the inside, blowing it outside, this will be quite inefficient for your heating system. In other words, the vented dryer, when running, will contribute to cool down the room environment in winter. Condenser dryers suck air from the room. They have then a heat exchanger, which is effectively a heating element, to warm up the air. The fan allows the hot air to circulate in the drum. The hot air extracts moisture from the laundry. This moist air travels in the condensing container, which is stored as water, this machine uses a simple exchanger with running water to allow moisture to condensate in the condenser container. About every 2 weeks, you would need to clean fluff and lint filters. Condenser dryers would need a good ventilation in the room. In fact, due to the low efficiency in moisture extraction, they release moisture in circulation in the room. Whirlpool released a learning video that explains brilliantly how heat pump dryers work. Let's watch it.
A heat pump dryer uses heat pump technology to generate heat during the cycle. It is ventless, which makes it easy to install anywhere, and it is the most energy efficient option on the market. This is how heat pump technology works. On the left side of the dryer, a sealed system generates heat by compressing freon gas, eliminating the need for a heating element. The blower pushes air through a primary lint filter, then a secondary lint filter, and then through an evaporator, where moisture is extracted. Finally, a heat exchanger adds heat before the warm, dry air re-enters the dryer drum, and the cycle is repeated. But where does the moisture go once extracted from the heat pump? There are two options. In the first, moisture is pumped into a reservoir at the top of the dryer. An indicator light appears when the reservoir is full, prompting the user to empty it. The second option removes the water through a washer drain stack at the back of the dryer. This is the most preferred method, needing no interaction from the consumer. The heat pump dryer comes with two lint filters. The primary filter is to be cleaned before every load, and a secondary filter needs to be cleaned after every 5.
Let's now look at time, power consumption, and costs. In this section, we'll make an example with similar dryers in terms of capacity, but with different technologies. We'll see how long do they take to complete an average cycle with cotton, machine power consumption, and costs. We'll focus in the comparison between condenser dryers and heat pump. For this comparison, I choose 8 kilo Tumble dryers. For the vented one, we have a model from Hoover. From the user manual, we can see that to complete a drying cycle with cotton, it takes about 147 minutes. At this moment, November 2021, the UK price for this machine is £229, which corresponds to $311. From the manufacturer website, we can see that the annual energy consumption for this machine is about 580 kilowatts hour. In this example, I used the average electricity price in November 2021 that I have got from this website, and for the UK from this other website. But in reality, you should use the price you pay for your electricity in your specific case. For example, in my case, I have been recently forced to switch to a new energy supplier, where the new energy price is much higher than the UK average. For the condenser and heat pump, I have got two machines that are very, very similar in features. They are both Bosch 8 series, same functionality, but different technology. So this will be a brilliant example. The drying time for cotton is 137 minutes for the condenser and 159 minutes for the heat pump. In fact, condenser dryers are notably faster. The UK price for the condenser dryer is £669, which is about $913 at today's current exchange rate. Same process as before, this is the calculation for the energy consumption for the Bosch condenser dryer. With regards to the heat pump dryer instead, the UK price for the machine is £779, which corresponds to $1,063. The energy cost for the year is 25.3 pounds, which is $24.5. The difference in cost between the two machines is 110 pounds, which is about $150. I used the negative sign in this case to highlight the fact that this is an additional cost for the heat pump dryer. But the heat pump dryer, as expected, is cheaper to run, and you would have a positive saving of 55.5 pounds in the UK and $53.5 in the US. Probably for me the difference will be even higher, as I have an higher electricity price from my provider. Therefore, summing up, an average UK user would cover the additional cost of the heat pump dryer on the condenser dryer in about 2 years, while the US average consumer, it will take about 3 years to cover the premium paid up front. In my case, the difference was way higher. For this reason, I opted for the heat pump. The review for this machine is linked above. Those are enough information for you to buy your Tumble dryer, and you can download the slide from the link in description below. If you enjoyed the video, please smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm, and consider to subscribe. It will help us a lot, and you can always change your mind. Guys, see you in the next video!